America, after two frustrating delays, hopes this morning to launch its second man on a ride into space.
He is Air Force Captain Virgil Grissom, shown here as 3 hours ago he emerged from the van which had taken him from Hangar S, where he was prepared for this flight, out to the launch pad and for his trip to perhaps outer space. He rode up the elevator to the capsule and there prepared for his trip. The plastic overshoes that protected his spacesuit shoes were taken off, and then he rested on the steps of the capsule, that is the steps that are rolled alongside the capsule, up which he goes to go into the capsule through that small hatch. Then he started into the capsule, being lowered into the capsule and into the contour chair specially built for him, into which he will be strapped for his flight. Captain Grissom is 35 years old, at 5 feet 7 inches, the shortest of the astronauts. At 35 years old, the second youngest. He is married, two boys, 11 and 7 years old. They and Betty Grissom, his wife, will be watching this launch from their home near Langley Field, the home of the astronauts. You see Grissom here in that 19 pounds of aluminized rubber suit that is his space costume, as he climbs the steps, lowers himself down into the hatch and into that contour chair. In this 6 by 9 foot capsule crammed with the instruments that will monitor his flight, that will permit him to control the pitch and the yaw of his capsule, though not its direction, in its ballistic flight 115 miles into the sky and 290 miles downrange. Grissom is ready, the Mercury capsule is ready, the Redstone rocket is ready, downrange the aircraft carrier Randolph and 5 destroyers of the recovery force are ready. Here in Mercury Control, which you see there, the backup pilot, Lieutenant Colonel Glenn of the Marine Corps, is ready, as is Alan Shepard, our first astronaut at the communications capsule. Now let's take a look at our correspondents around the field.
Putting an electrocardiograph. In the event of trouble, Dr. Stan White can order the flight halted at once. Others will monitor the condition of the spacecraft and flight path of the Redstone. Especially important to the astronaut here at Mercury Control is America's first astronaut, Alan Shepard, whose job is capsule communicator. He'll be in constant radio communication with Grissom during the flight. Also in hand today is Space Administrator James Webb, who came down a couple hours ago himself to observe this important step in Project Mercury. This is Robert Lodge at Mercury Control.
We will listen now to the countdown and watch the scene here at Cape Canaveral. You just saw the umbilical cord come away from the capsule.
30 seconds and counting.
That means that all ground contact with the capsule, with the rocket, has now ended.
Periscope has retracted. T-minus 15 seconds and counting. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Ignition, lift off, lift off. Confirmed at Mercury Control and by the pilot. Lift off and let launch is operating. Just recorded, it's a nice ride up there.
It looks good, it looks like a good launch. Go, baby, go. Should be a little pitch over here to go into trajectory.
It looks like a good launch.
Trajectory is A-OK. Flight surgeon reports the pilot is in excellent physical condition. Gus reports he's picking up a little bit of the noise and vibration. The fuel is go, 1.5 G. The cabin pressure has settled down to 5. Trajectory reported go. All systems reporting go. Cabin pressure holding 5.5. Fuel is go, 2.5 G's. Oxygen is go. All systems are go, and Gus Grissom sounds like a very confident test pilot today. Liberty Bell 7, the U.S. Mercury spacecraft with pilot Gus Grissom at the controls, traveled 5,310 miles an hour. He reached a maximum altitude of 118 statute miles. His flight path carried him 6 nautical miles farther than was planned, and he landed 305 statute miles downrange from the launch site. I'll review those numbers again. The Mercury spacecraft traveled a maximum velocity of 5,310 miles an hour. It reached a maximum altitude of 118 miles. It traveled 305 miles downrange before landing in the Atlantic. And we are still standing by here in Mercury Control for final information on the time when Mercury astronaut Grissom was lifted out of his spacecraft, and the time, if possible, when he was put down on the deck of the Randolph.
There's some concern at the present time. The astronaut, Mercury Grissom, is out of the capsule, swimming in the water. The capsule itself is apparently sinking lower into the water, and there is fear that it might sink completely below the surface of the water. 4 helicopters are all hovering very close to the astronaut and the capsule out there. They're making an attempt to get a cable to Virgil Grissom, who is protected, of course. He will float. There's no problem about that, and they'll get him out. The concern at the time is with the capsule itself. And it looks like Grissom is coming up now. It looks like Grissom is coming up out of the water and is being held. And we can see him now. He's about 4 miles from us and being held up. And the helicopter is holding up the capsule itself. We're checking on Grissom again, but the helicopter has a cable aboard the capsule and is holding it up at the present time. Grissom, it appears, is about ready to be lifted. We can't see too well at the present time. This carrier has been traveling at high speed to get close to the side of the recovery. It's now about 3.5 miles away. We have to watch and see if we can from the line. And the helicopter is hovering over and holding the capsule up. The capsule was sinking badly in the water, and that's the reason that Virgil Grissom got out of the capsule.
As you may have heard, there are some people here in the Mercury Control Center who are very, very happy. I'll repeat what happened downrange in the pickup area. We know that the helicopter attempted the pickup of the Mercury spacecraft. We know that Virgil Gus Grissom got aboard the helicopter. We also know that some kind of malfunction occurred. The spacecraft was dropped in the ocean and sank. And this is John Powers in the Mercury Control Center signing off at this time.
Before the unfortunate incident in which the helicopter lost the capsule and dropped it back into the ocean, we had heard from Batchelder aboard the Randolph that the capsule seemed to be sinking, so apparently there was a leakage in the capsule which caused the original difficulty. It might be recalled that this was the principal malfunction in the flight of the chimpanzee Ham back at the early part of the year. And the thing that gave the astronauts and the entire Mercury Project officers the greatest concern after the... Just one moment. Just after the Ham flight, They were concerned about this leakage in the capsule that Ham flew downrange and delayed the launch of an astronaut long enough for several more tests from Wallops Island, the smaller Cape Canaveral, to test capsule recovery procedures and to test the capsules themselves. However, until there is a full report from Grissom as to what happened to his capsule, this is all speculation at the moment.